Hey everyone, April Dunnam here. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use the file attachment capability of Microsoft Forms and create a flow in Power Automate that takes that information and the attachment and writes that out to a list in SharePoint. This was a pretty highly requested topic in the previous video that I did on moving Microsoft Forms data to Microsoft List. So I thought I would do a quick video walking you through how we can now take those attachments and move those at the same time into our SharePoint list, either as an attachment to the list item or in a SharePoint document library. There's a few steps involved to this, but I'll break it all down for you right after this. Okay, first things first, let's see how we get the form set up in Microsoft Forms to handle file attachments. So I have a form that I created to get information for session requests for a conference. So I've added single line of text fields for first name, last name, and you'll notice what I have here. I have a profile picture field where they can upload their picture. So to get a file upload in your Microsoft Forms, just click Add New, click on the drop down there, and we'll see a new file upload option. And when you add one of these in, there's a few different settings that you need to configure. First, you have to choose how many files to limit this field to. We can also choose the single file size limit. We can set that to 10 megabytes, 100 megabytes, or 1 gig. So just choose the option there for your needs. And then that's really all we need to do from the forms side itself. Next thing I did is I went into SharePoint and I created a list that contains all of those fields in it. I'm reusing the title field for the last name. I created a single line of text for first name, job title, email, and session title. In that profile picture file attachment, I want to actually attach that here directly on the item. So as you can see, I've tested this workflow already. I have a file attachment, and there is the picture in the attachment that was saved from the Microsoft form. To get this all synchronized and working though, we need some Power Automate. So let's go over to Power Automate, click on My Flows, and we'll click the New Flow option and choose the automated cloud flow. So we'll give our flow a name. So we'll call this Power Platform Bootcamp Sessions. And then for the trigger, we'll select the when a new response is submitted in Microsoft Forms. Click Create. I'll choose my form from the dropdown here, the Power Platform Bootcamp call for speakers. And now we need to get the response details. So we'll do a new step. I'll just type get response. And the first one that pops up there is Microsoft Forms get response details. That's what we want. We'll choose the form again from this dropdown. And for the response ID, we'll point it to the item from the trigger, which we have here in our dynamic content. It's the response ID field. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I want to create an item in the SharePoint list to hold all of that static data. So not the profile picture of any of that, just the first name, last name, and all that static information. Then we'll go back in after that and add that attachment in. So to create the item, we'll add a new step, do a search for create item, and we'll choose the SharePoint create item action. I'll select the training site from the site address dropdown, and I have a list called Power Platform Bootcamp Submissions, and that's where I'm going to be storing the data. Now I'll just map my properties. Now is where we're actually going to do the work, where we're going to pull that attachment for the profile picture from this form. So there are a couple steps involved here. Now you might be tempted to just create a new step, search for add attachment, and choose the SharePoint add attachment action, and just point the file name and file content properties to this profile picture field from our Microsoft form. This isn't going to work though, because that object there doesn't store the file content or the file name that we need to actually pull in there. We need to go do two separate actions to get that. We need to first extract out the name of the file. Then we need to actually go and make a call from where it's actually stored. So that leads us into the first question. When we're leveraging that attachment capability in Microsoft Forms, where is that physically storing the file? Well, behind the scenes, when you configure and set up a form leveraging the file attachment capability, it's storing the files in the OneDrive for Business account of the person that created the form. So I set up that Power Platform Bootcamp form, and if I go to my OneDrive for Business account, I see what it does is it creates an apps folder, and within that apps folder, we have a Microsoft Forms folder. If we keep drilling down now into the Microsoft Forms folder, we see we have another folder which is associated with the name of my form. So every form that you have, if it includes an attachment, it'll be shown here in this folder. So apps, Microsoft Forms, and then your form name. Now, if we keep drilling down into this, I'll go into this folder for my form. We see we have question and question one. These are the two attachments I have. Now, I only showed one, but if we go back to the form, I actually do have another attachment for session abstract and resources. So unfortunately, the names aren't super intuitive. It really goes by the order in which you add the file attachment field in. So if you do have multiple attachment fields in your forms, you kind of have to know which one you added first for these names of the folders where they're stored to make sense. Now, I happen to know that I added the profile picture one second, so that means it's probably this question one folder. So if I dive into that, I will see the two pictures that I know I have uploaded in my testing so far. So we're going to need to know this file path to be able to look up the contents and retrieve that of this file. But we actually need to do something before we even mess with retrieving this file from our OneDrive. We need to get the name of the file, because the only way to look up and find that file is with having that complete path with the file name. So how do we get the name of the file? Before we can figure that out, we need to actually save what we have so far, and we want to submit a test. So we actually want to run through submitting an item in that form so that we can see the outputs of that. So let's go back to our form. I'm going to open it up in preview, and I'm going to fill something in. And let me upload an image here, and then click submit. Now we'll go back to our flow, and we'll click out of here, and we'll look at the run history. So I can see it ran, so we want to inspect the run history now and expand out this get response details action that we see succeeded. This is where we'll find out the format that we need to be able to extract the name of our image. So if we look at the profile picture property here in our get response details, you see that object there, that field, is actually a block of JSON. So we see I have a property called name with a value. We have another property called link, which is actually where the file is stored. We have other properties for ID, type, size, and reference ID. This is why we couldn't just point that field directly in our add attachments action, because it's not just a file content or a file name. We need to do something called parsing this JSON to extract out just the information we need, in this case, the name of the file. So this is the whole reason why we had to test it. We needed to get to this. So what we're going to do is we're going to copy what's in this profile picture attachment field that we see here, this block of JSON. And now we're going to go back into our edit mode, and we need to add an action in here to parse this. So let's add a new step and do a search for parse. We want this data operations parse JSON action. For the content property here, we're going to click in that box, and this is where we want to point to our attachment field, which in my case is profile picture. Now we need to give it a sample of what the JSON will look like. That's why we tested it and we copied that. So what we'll do is we'll click generate from sample and we'll paste what we copied in here. Now just click done. And now we have a way to get to that name. Now we can do that call to OneDrive for Business and pull the file content. So what we'll do is we'll click new step. We'll do a search for get file content, and we'll choose the get file content using path for the OneDrive for Business connector. Now this needs a complete file path. So we'll have to go back to what we were looking at earlier with the OneDrive. And we need to look at this total file path and type that in manually there in that OneDrive for Business action. I've already typed this out and I'm lazy, so I'm just gonna paste that right in there. So you wanna start it with a forward slash, then you'll have the name of the first folder, which is apps. And another forward slash, the Microsoft Forms folder, another forward slash, and the name of your form, and a final forward slash and the name of the folder where your field that has the attachment is. Now the last thing to do is now we need to pull in the file name. So we have a final forward slash, and this is where we need to pull that in, and we need to use an expression in Power Automate for this. Now you notice here in the dynamic content window, under the parse JSON header, these are all those properties that we had from that block of JSON. So the one that we're trying to get to is this name property. That's where the file name is stored. Now I can't just click on that and then have that be the name of my file in the file path, because it recognizes this as an array. So we need to use a function called first to get the first object there that contains the name. So I'm going to click on the expression tab, and we're going to use that first function. And then we're just going to pass in the name of that name field from our parse JSON action. So let's click OK on this. So we see that populate there. And I'm a compulsive saver, so I'm going to save this one more time. All right, there's only one thing left to do. We need to actually add that attachment now because we have everything we need. So all that we're going to do now is click New Step again, do a search for Add Attachment, choose the SharePoint Add Attachment option, choose the site address and list name again. And for the ID, we'll point that to the ID from our Create Item action. And now it's time for the file name. So we'll do that same expression. We'll switch over to the expression option, paste that in, click OK. And for the file content, you'll see in the dynamic content window now, we have that get file content using path, and we have a file content property that we can pass in. All right, that is all that is needed. So let's save this and let's run the test. So I'm gonna jump back over to our form, fill it out here. We'll upload a picture, click submit. Now let's jump back over to our flow. Let's look at that run history. See, we have a successful run 3 seconds ago. So if we kind of peek at what's going on here, if I look at my parse JSON, I can see that data being populated there with the name. I can see the get file content succeeded. So if we look at OneDrive, for example, I see that new picture was added just a few seconds ago. And final moment of truth, if I go to my SharePoint list, I'll see there is the item. And if I open that up, I see the attachment. I can click on that and it opens right up. We can make a simple modification to this if we didn't want to add this as an attachment, but rather in a document library. All we'd have to do in that case, if I go back to the edit mode here, is replace the add attachment action with the create file action for SharePoint. Point that to the site address and the folder path. So I'll just choose this generic shared documents library. And same thing for the file name. So they will use that expression here, getting the name from our parse JSON action and the file content from our get content using file path OneDrive connector. So now if I click save, this should be in two places. And rather than submit that form again, I'll just do a test. So I'll use our nifty testing function in Flow. I'll do with a recent trigger, click test. It ran successfully. So let's go back to SharePoint, look in that document library, and there's the profile picture. Now, just one more thing that I want to point out before I let you go. If you recall in the options here in our file attachment on our form, we had the option to have a file number limit. So if you did set that to maybe allow someone to upload more than one file in the attachment, this will slightly change the process that we just went through in your flow. So really, we can do all of the same things. A main thing that would change here is in the get file content path and the add attachment actions here. If you allowed multiple file attachments in that field, you wouldn't want to use the first function because that's only returning one item. Instead, you would point it directly to this parse JSON name. And when you do that, and I'll just show you real quickly what happens, it's going to wrap your add attachment action inside and apply to each. So this will do a loop for you, looping through all the attachments and getting that name property. And same thing with the get file content from path. Don't use the first, point directly to the name so that it can do the looping through all the different attachments there. All right, well, that pretty much wraps it up. If you found this helpful, do me a favor, like, subscribe, share, and I'll catch you in the next video.